Oh, hi guys. Thanks for dropping by. As you know, my name is Ricky. I'm with the Explorers of the Paranormal and Unexplainable. And today I'm bringing you a video on astral projection. What is astral projection? Well, stick around and find out in just a moment. Thanks for coming back and thanks for staying with me. As I said before the intro, I want to discuss astral projection today. And give you a summary on what it is. If you have not heard of it before or you have heard of it before, I'm going to kind of give it based on if you haven't heard of it before. Now, I got some information here. I'm going to also put it up on the screen here with you as well. And we're going to kind of read over a little bit of information that I got here. Now, I am looking on Wikipedia. I mean, it's not the greatest source in the world, but astral projection or astral travel is a term used in esotericism to describe an intentional out-of-body experience or an OBE. This means it's deliberate. You wanted to do it. It wasn't accidental. It could be either consciously or subconsciously done. Most people practice it to do it consciously, which is the challenge. Unconsciously means you do it without even trying, you might not be aware of it. You might even come up with, hey, that was a dream or something. And that's considered a lucid dream, which is where you know you're dreaming while you're still dreaming, which I've done plenty of times. This is another video I may do later on as well. And it is sometimes reported in association with dreams and forms of meditation. Now, they actually do say meditation is the greatest tool to achieve conscious and deliberate out-of-body experiences or astral projection. Meditation is a form of quieting your mind to a point where you basically go into some sort of a trance. The goal is for your body to basically go to sleep while your mind stays conscious and awake. At that point, if you go deep enough, you can separate from your body. And that's the goal of people who want to do astral projection. The way of doing it is using what they would consider a hallucinogenic drug. I'm sure you probably heard of DMT, ayahuasca, which is a really potent hallucinogen that basically helps you separate from the ego. Now, the ego, in my opinion, is what this shell I'm using, this vessel, that's the ego. My consciousness is what's seen behind these eyes, that voice in my head. And the two coexist together simultaneously. But also pretty popular in pop culture these days. A lot of these shows you probably heard of, Insidious, is a pretty well-known horror movie that just came out where another boy named Dalton, whose astral body gets caught in the demonic realm, and his father has to somehow astral project and go get his kid's soul back and bring back to his body. If you watch Avatar: The Last Airbender, The Legend of Korra, when he goes and does his meditations, he's able to actually go into the spirit world. That's basically another form of astral projection. As in Marvel's Doctor Strange. You know the scene where he's talking with the Ancient One and he's basically arguing with her that he doesn't believe in this metaphysical stuff. He just wants to get use of his hands back. And while he's arguing with her, she somehow knocks his astral form out of his body and then brings it back into his body, proving to him that it's real. And I'm going to put a short clip of that right here.
But I see through you!
I pushed your astral form out of your physical form.
What's in that tea?
So yeah, what do you think of that? If you haven't seen the movie already, definitely check it out. But basically, what that scene just showed is the astral body outside of the physical body. I've only done conscious astral projection twice. Once, years ago, I was asleep. And I'd already been studying astral projection at the time. But anyways, I woke up and I felt calm. I felt relaxed. So what I did, I just laid there. I didn't even open my eyes. And I attempted to move. And before I knew it, I could feel myself standing into my bedroom. My eyes were still closed. I couldn't see anything. I didn't have enough practice of being able to visually observe one of my astral form. It didn't last long. It's a couple of seconds, and then poof, I was back in my body. I woke up. The second time it happened was pretty recent. It was here in this house. I was sitting in a chair here, watching TV. It had been a long day. I was tired. So before I knew it, I fell asleep. I came to. I was sitting in a chair, but I was deeply relaxed. I was calm. But I was conscious. So I tried the same thing as the previous time. My eyes were closed. I couldn't see anything. And I just stood up, just like I would normally physically stand up. But instead of physically stand up, my astral body stood up. And I had just, you know, not even able to open my eyes yet, because I was still unable to. I never had enough practice. But anyways, as I was getting ready to experiment with it, some commotion happened with my roommate, and I woke up, and it snapped me out of it, you know, so And since then, I've only done it subconsciously or unconsciously in the form of vivid dreams or lucid dreams where you know you're dreaming while you're dreaming, like I said earlier in the video. And that's also, it can be seen as a form of astral projection because you're basically conscious while out of your body or not using your body. Your body is asleep, but you're still existing out there beyond it, which is really fascinating. I just love the concept of not being trapped in this vessel here. Now you might ask, what's the point of astral projection? Well, that's a good question, and I don't know the answer. But there's a whole vast reality that exists out there beyond this three-dimensional world we live in. When you astral project, you're not bound to that anymore. You can travel to what's called the astral plane. And in my opinion, that's an area or a dimension that exists in between dimensions. It's etheric. It's non-physical. It's a reality based of energy and light, you know, a higher vibrational, whatever you want to call it. And also there, they say, exists what's called the Akashic Records, or the Universal Library, that's said to contain all knowledge of the universe. Also, in one of my other videos, I visited what I call the city, or the astral city, and I will put a link to that video right here, so if you want to check it out, click on it, watch it as well. I'm going to give you an idea of one of my unconscious projections. Another way of doing this, people who have what's called near-death experiences, NDEs, they're in some sort of traumatic accidents. And while their body's unconscious or being operated on or resuscitated, let's say their heart stops, they're medically, technically dead. People have said they see themselves on a table being worked on, and they're floating above their bodies looking down. And they have been said to travel out and see the tunnel, which is associated with Christianity. When you die, you go into the light at the end of the tunnel, and that's where you go to heaven. People have spoken about seeing that as well. And then, for whatever reason, we're told it wasn't their time, and they came back. But that's a whole other story. The light in the tunnel, near the experiences, that's unintentional. It just happens. But astral projection, like I said at the beginning of the video, is an intentional practice in which you leave your physical body and go explore anywhere you want to, basically. There's no limits. You can travel at the speed of thought. If you want to go somewhere, even before you think it, you're there. And one common misconception is, can you get lost? Can you get stuck out of your body? No. It's actually harder to stay out of your body than to get back in it. If you come out of your body successfully and you're doing this, and if you have any amount of fear, you're back in your body. If you're going out too far and let's say somebody opens your door to your room and it distracts you, you're back in your body. People say, can you die right out of your body? Well, you can naturally die if something happens. Let's say you're out and about and you have a heart attack. Something happens like that, but you cannot die from astral projection. In fact, your body and your astral form and consciousness is always linked together via what they call the silver cord. And supposedly that link's been there since birth. It'll be there till death. And until death, will that cord be severed? People have reported while out and about astrally looking down to where their belly button would be. And they have seen the silver cord stretching out indefinitely. And if they followed it back, it would go to their body. So there's no fear on being lost or dying while projecting. People have also asked, can your body be possessed while you're projecting? Again, no. Because technically, you're connected to your body. You're just remotely, you know, out of it using the projection techniques, but you're still connected to it. So no entity could just come in and take over your body and possess you while you're out. That's not going to happen. At least not that I've seen or heard. If it has, let me know. So I'm going to wrap up here. I feel like I've gotten a pretty good topic with what I've talked about here. Have you ever experienced projection? Have you practiced it? Have you done it successfully? Let me know in those comments. And like it. And if you haven't already, subscribe. Keep an eye out for more content. I plan to put out 2 videos a week. My plan, if I can stay on topic, would be Tuesdays, which is tonight, and Saturday. So Tuesdays and Saturdays, I plan to drop new videos. If you want to see those, subscribe. Hit the bell notification so it will tell you when new videos come out. And I do appreciate you watching. Thank you again for dropping by. And you have a great rest of your day. And if you are projecting and successfully doing it, congratulations on that. Give us tips and let us know how to do it. I'm still trying to do it successfully. But in the meantime, keep your eyes open, keep your mind open, explore the unexplainable and the paranormal. Until next time, guys. This is Ricky, and I'm out.